So hello, in this video I will introduce you two platforms for running deep learning models. This video is divided into five parts: introduction to highlight the need to improve the current platform, methodology for segmentations. We use a use case study as an illustration to present our two platforms. Third part, where we present the two platforms and the modules we have developed on them. In the fourth part, I explain the interest of these platforms and the contribution they make. Finally, we will conclude on what we have seen. Today, the experimental field is increasingly using machine learning and deep learning models. In this process of analyzing experimental data, we see that for the case of plant phenotyping, for example, image analysis requires the manipulation of deep learning and machine learning models. Especially, these models are nowadays more and more used. If you look at the three graphs below, in experimental fields, scientists are generally new to model development, especially deep learning models and machine learning models. Several platforms are available to them to facilitate this manipulation. We mentioned two platforms. In Imagi, the DeepImagi plugin is widely used in image analysis. It allows image inference from a pre-trained model. This plugin has two disadvantages. It is only written in Python, and under this language, it is very difficult to customize this plugin. The second platform is Google Colab, a service offered by Google. This platform allows the development of deep learning and machine learning models from a notebook by offering an efficient processing resources. However, the problem is the need for math and programming skills by the user. Also, the data used and the model are exploitable by Google, since the host of Google Colab is Google itself. So in our video, we propose two platforms that overcome these drawbacks. To present this platform, we use a use case as an illustration. Our use case is a binary image segmentation model. We want to segment apple blossoms here. We have a total of 100 images, and the particularity of this data set is the data is unbalanced. Then we explain how the developed model works and present our two platforms. At the end, we will talk about the contribution provided by these platforms. Here we have our database and evaluation metrics. We have 50 RGB images and 50 masks, not enough for an efficient training of our model. We use the DICE and weighted binary cross entropy, DICE for the quality of segmentation, and weighted binary cross entropy as a loss function. These two elements is used to overcome the class imbalance problem. In pre-processing, we ship images to obtain a sufficient data set to train our model. Next, we use the UNet algorithm to segment our images. In a nutshell, the algorithm determines patterns by oversampling and undersampling the images by concatenating the probability maps in the decoding phase. Finally, an optimal segmentation threshold is determined from an algorithm. We search for the best F1 score by a set of candidate thresholds. This model shows a good performance. For the DICE metric, the validation curve and the trend curve are increasing and are close. For the loss function, the curves are decreasing towards zero and are close. We conclude that we have a good model, and 70% of the flower pixels are very well predicted by our model. So this model will be deployed on two platforms. Napari. NAPADI is a large image viewer written in Python. We can process our images. We have standard tools to process our image. Plugins are used to add additional tools for processing. Plugin development is open to all, and this platform written in Python allows us to invite the large Python community to exploit this tool. We have developed a plugin that is the inference of our model. The inference code is displayed in front of you. This code was written in Google Colab. It consists of only 7 steps: image input, preprocessing, load the model, we feed the images for our model, segmentation and application of the optimal threshold in the image, and we get at the end the mask of segmentation. This code has been deployed on NAPADI. We simply adapted the code from the NAPADI framework. So the plugin was developed using Magic GUI Decorator. The first function is the inference function. It is the same code that we saw here. The second function to upload the image. And the last function is to run the inference. A tutorial on how to use it has been produced and can be found in the HeimoFan YouTube channel. The development of this plugin has been praised by the NAPADI community and the Chan Zuckerberg Initiative. So now we present the second platform, the DeepIce for Deep Hybrid Data Cloud. This platform is a web service for inferring and training a model in web in internet. So it is a web service in internet. So the functioning of this platform is summarized in this graph. The principle is based on the REST API. I mean, a user sends an image into the API, and the API sends it to a module in a Docker. Once the image is processed, the result is sent back to the API and sent to the user. On this principle, we can make inference and retraining of a model present in a module. We can also deploy our own module. For example, in inference, a user can classify the image here and see his result directly in the platform here and export this result. For retraining, a user trains his model and then visualizes the evolution of the learning and validation curves in the TensorBoard tool. The training history is also presented in the module. So we have developed a module named Blossom module. This module have 2 tools, inference and training. So model N is used to perform the inference here. If the inference is good, so we do nothing, but if the result of the inference is bad, so we can collect manually with the pixel collection plugin of NAPADI. These collected images are stored in a publicly accessible Google Drive directory. If this directory has a sufficient number of images for a retraining, a data scientist can retrain the model. If the result of this retraining are bad, so we do nothing, the code do nothing automatically. But if the results are good, then the module N plus one is downloaded into your Nextcloud repository. So the contribution here, the contribution for NAPADI is a user can interact directly with the data, and in the plugin, user can interact with each steps of the process. The second advantages is the Napari is able to visualize 2D and 3D data without using in local high performance graphics processor. And the module and the source code is open access. For the DeepAS, the improvement of the model through the user collaboration is now available with our module Blossom. And when we combine Napari and DeepAS, we can see that both platforms are written in Python, so we can open the module design to all. So to conclude, we have developed one operational module for segmentation deployed into Napari and DeepAS to all community scientific community. The access of the module can be seen via a video tutorial and the source code into GitHub. So now we can go to the demo of the plugin that we developed, Napari, and the module that we developed in DeepAS. So first we go to a demo in Napari. So if you have not Napari installed into your PC, you can go to the Napari website and follow the instruction to install. So to install Napari as a bundle application, you can go in this page, in tutorial fundamental installation, and click here to install the Napari according to your exploitation system, Linux, macOS, or Windows. So I already installed Napari in my PC, so I run Napari. So here we have the Napari window. We can access the plugin by click here, and Napari Blossom plugin is here. If to install the Napari Blossom plugin or other plugin in your PC, you can go install plugins, and we have a menu of all accessible available plugins to install in your PC. So the plugin that we are interested in here is Napari Blossom. Napari Blossom have a free widget. Here to upload our image, here to make an inference of our image, and here to save the mask segmentation into a zip file. So first, we upload our image, select a file, we select our image here, and we choose this image, for example. We load the image into our Napari widget, Windows. We go back to the Napari plugin and select model segmentation to run the inference. So we run the inference. So now we can see the inference is done. So we can download the result of segmentation with this widget. We click here to export our mask segmentation into a zip file. So we save this into desktop and output Blossom zip file. So we save. So message here say that the compressed file is done. Then we can see the file into the desktop and desktop Blossom, and we can see the same image here. So the Napari demo is done, so we can go to the next demo of DeepAS. So DeepAS, first it is very necessary to have two elements. First, an account into Nextcloud and an account into DeepAS. you should contact the DSpace administration to have an account into DSpace and Nextcloud. Once you have these two elements, we can make the demo. So for the Nextcloud, here we will store our data. So first you create a data here, a data folder. Into this folder, we can create three folders, a folder for image, a folder for our model, and a folder output to store all output of image of our train tools. So once we have this, we can go to DSpace. So we have here DSpace, and if we click here into the modules, we have the marketplace here. You can see all modules present currently in the DSpace. We can see, for example, a module for plant species classifier, seed species classifier. But the module that we are interested in is apple tree blossom image segmentation. So here we have the module, some information of this module, and we can go here to configure our module. I remind you that we can make two things into this module. We can make an inference and we can make training. So first we will see the inference. So for inference, you click here and select DSpace. You keep all information here, but you have to write the username of your Nextcloud and the password of your Nextcloud. You can get this information into your Nextcloud. So you go into your Nextcloud, here, parameter, security, and create a new password. So here we will write AirShare as the name of your application and as password and a username we will give you in automatically. So I already have my password and my username. You can configure it also the amount of memory, the number of required CPU, and the number of required GPU. You click submit. In my case, I already submit my model. So we can click for inference. You can click here and click DSpace. So once the page is done, we have this page here. For inference, you go here, Blossom Predict. You click Try it out to activate the prediction and choose your image. So here you can see, you can make as input an image or a zip file. So we select here an image and execute. So here the inference is done, so we click download. And we have the inference result here. Now for training, you need to close here and go to the module marketplace. Go back here and click again the module and train the module. So I remind you that for inference, you have to select DeepIS as a command. But for a training, you have to select JupyterLab as a command. So you can configure all information here. But you select JupyterLab, so you have to write a password here. So I wrote my password. The same way at the previous things, you write here your password and the username, the username of your Nextcloud. So my username and my password. I can fill all information for hardware here and click submit. But in my case, I already deployed my model. So we click access here, and we click JupyterLab. So here we have the JupyterLab, and we go to the terminal. And you have to write a DeepIS run. Listen IP 0.0.0. So after you write this, you click OK and you go back here, access and DeepIS. So go here, DeepIS, and I remind you that for the inference, you go here. Now we want to retrain the model, so we go here. Try out to activate the train configuration. You can write some elements here: learning rate, the kernel, batch size, epoch, etc., and the type of loss. So the loss function is weighted loss. And we execute the training. So in my case, I already trained some models before. So here we have some interesting model. So I make a retraining in CPU. And in CPU, the time is 29 minutes. So I got a lot of wrong models, and at the end, I got an information that the model is wrong, is worse, and I get a general information on the input here, and the name of files if the model was good. So here, the model is good, so we have all information here. The information here of retrain is better, so the model is good, and this information will be uploaded into my Nextcloud folder. So I go into my Nextcloud folder, repository, data and output, because this information export automatically into output, and I got those elements. I got the model and the weight of the model. I got the optimal threshold of segmentation and a general summary. So in this file, we can see the date when the retraining happened, some information entered by the user, hyperparameter, and some information of the result of our model, this value and this value for the retrain model and existing model, and if the retrain model is good or not. So the demonstration is over. So thank you for your attention.